All right, gonna go ahead and do a Sunday video. We don't have trading tomorrow, but for Tuesday, gonna go over the three scenarios I see possible for Tuesday. And we'll start off with the first scenario is we are in an impulsive move. So we have one, two, three, and then presumably four right here. On the video I did last, I shorted it here at the very top, and that was one of my best trades in probably about a month. I actually held it all the way from about 400 down to 390.75, so that was a pretty good profit there. I'm not sure currently if I, for the reason I thought I was holding it, but it worked out. So we'll go over the three different scenarios where I think we're going to go from here. First one, like I said, is an impulsive move. We have one, two, three. I'm pretty sure, I'm very confident this is actually one, two, and this is another impulsive move for the overall third wave. I don't think we are still in the third wave. So from here, if this is a five-wave move, though, I would like to see A, B, and then another move up here to 400, 401 for a flat. So ABC for a flat, that'd be the overall fourth wave. The reason I want to see another move up is this looks like a B wave, and on the daily time frame, I would like to see a green candle. So we need to get one, two, three, four, maybe have a day or two going up to 400, and then finally for the fifth wave, if that were to take place, we'd be looking at for 380 to 375. So I'll go ahead and put a line down here. That would be for impulsive move right here. So impulsive right there. Get rid of this for now. I don't think it's very likely. Well, this is another scenario, but I don't think this is very likely. Like I said, because I'm pretty confident this is the full impulsive wave. Very slim chance that we do A, and then this continues on lower than 390.13. If that happens, then I would actually consider the third wave not done. I would reconsider my count, but this right here looks like a B wave, so I think that we probably hit the support here and we're going to bounce. But if it was, if it did end up being a fifth wave and my count changed a little bit, I would be looking for not much more, because if you go on the 5-minute time frame, you can see you could possibly count it as a five-wave move, one, two, three, four. And if that's the case, we're looking at one, two, three, four, and then a gap down, basically. It would have to be a gap down, pretty much, below this. And in that scenario, I would be looking for... what I originally was looking for, which was like 388, 389. So that's the least likely scenario for a gap down, and that would be the overall third wave down here at 388, 389. So we have the impulsive move that I'm expecting to 401, and then down for an overall fifth wave to at least 380. The less likely one, where we come down here to 388, 389 early on Tuesday. And then the other scenario is that this is actually an ABC move. And if this is an ABC move, we have A, B, C, impulsive wave, B, impulsive wave, C, and then we'd be looking at A, B, and then probably a move all the way up to the 1.61 fib, which is right around 408.31. This would be overall an A wave. So we have, I know this is getting kind of confusing with all these different labels, but we'd have A, and then we'd have B up here at like 408, and then we would want to see a C wave. And actually, currently, this would actually probably take us the lowest, because that C wave would be, we'd be looking at 363, or basically a double bottom with the June low, something like that. So this is for the actual corrective. But that would actually be the bottom, though. So we'd be A, B, C down here, probably within September sometime. So on the impulsive, obviously, this would be a fifth wave right here. So 16. And so those are the three scenarios, basically. So gap down, the least likely to 388, 389. The next scenario is a move to 401. That would be the fourth wave completing, basically, and we get a fifth wave down here to 380. If it's ABC, we're looking at ABC up here to 408 for a B wave, and then a C wave down here to the low 360s. And then after that, we'd probably move higher, or at least make a double top with this 430 range. So if you're a bull, you want to see it be a corrective, because that means we're going to bottom right here and then go back up. If you're a bear, you want this to be impulsive. You want to see it come up here to about 401 and then sell off to about 380. And then we can make a second wave back up here at 413, buy more puts, and then you would see a move down to 350 on the next move. So it really just depends on what we get on Tuesday. It's kind of hard to say right now, but those are the three most likely scenarios I see in the short term. Let's see what happens on Tuesday. But I'll say the majority, the most likely scenario is a move higher on Tuesday and a move towards at least 400. And if we look at the dollar too, pretty interesting. Now the dollar is actually going higher. Let's see, second, when did this open up at? So it opened up at 4 o'clock, and it's going higher currently. But I have this drawn out as being a corrective wave. So if you've been following my videos for a while, I've been saying that we need to get a fourth wave on this monthly chart for the dollar, and we just haven't gotten it yet. I think it's likely that we're almost there, and I think there's a very good chance that this is actually an expanded flat. If it holds about 105 or 110.35, I think we could see a minimum of 104.64 all the way down to 103.57. And I think that's pretty likely based on the structure. This B wave. So here's the top is what I'm thinking. A, B, C. I'm sorry. Is this right? I'm sorry. A, B, C. And then we got, on this B wave, you can see that it's a corrective move because we are not getting outside those parallel lines. Normally that works out on SPY. Currently, this isn't really the strategy isn't working out as much with the parallel lines, but right now this looks corrective. So we should see a move down for a expanded flat, but we'll have to watch it. If it breaks 110.35, then I would probably start thinking that we're still in the third wave. And then I would lean towards this being more of an impulsive move rather than a corrective move. Because if we're in a corrective move, then we want the dollar to go down. If the dollar goes down, SPY goes higher, basically. So then the VIX. The VIX, either way, I think this looks like a perfect setup to go lower. And I think SPY will go lower because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we're currently, we did A, B, and C, it looks like. However, if this is still going on, this corrective move, all we need to do is hold 1 of our 1916 and then break 28 or 2767, and the target would be around 33. And I think that's very likely. I don't know how far this corrective wave will go, but it already hit the 50% retracement, so we're already ready to go for this move to 33. But you never know. This could be A, B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 down here, and then we could go. So as long as it holds 1916 on the pullback, we're good to go to 33. So that's pretty much all I have right now. Summary, basically, looking for a bounce to 400 minimum. Very less likely we see a gap down to 388, 389 on Tuesday. If that happens, then I would rearrange my count. But it appears this is actually a B wave. So let me know what you think in the comments, and like and subscribe, and let me know what scenario you're leaning towards. What do you think is going to happen next week? And what do you think about my analysis? Let me know, and I will probably put out a video on Tuesday, possibly tomorrow, with another, maybe some other scenarios or something. All right, have a good night.